The latest version of Flutter has just landed on the stable channel, and it's packed with exciting new features. From quality of life updates that streamline aligning items in a list, to the ability to set weights for carousel items, and a host of enhancements to Cupertino widgets. So sit back as I guide you through the most notable improvements in Flutter 3.27. Let's start with something that might seem minor but is incredibly welcome. If you've been following this channel, you know how much I value minimalist and elegant code. Take this example. We have a list of boxes with text inside a column. To add spacing between them, I have used a sized box. You could also use a padding widget, which is a common approach you have probably seen many times before. Now, let me remove these sized box widgets. As expected, the boxes lose their spacing and stick together. However, in Flutter 3.27, we have an amazing new feature, the spacing property, which is available in both columns and rows. This property allows you to add spacing between elements with just a single value. It's a small improvement that might seem trivial, but if you're a fan of clean, simple, and elegant code like I am, you're going to love this functionality. Now, let's dive into an exciting improvement for the Carousel View widget. Here's an example. We have an image carousel complete with smooth animations, something already possible in previous Flutter versions. But with Flutter 3.27, a new secondary constructor named Weighted has been introduced. This lets you assign specific weights to the three visible elements on the screen, the central item and the adjacent ones on either side. For instance, you can make the center element take up twice as much space as the side elements, creating a visual striking effect. And the best part, you can customize the weights however you like, unlocking endless possibilities for effects and personalizing your carousel within your apps. This enhancement is undoubtedly a fantastic addition, making the Carousel View widget even more versatile and appealing to developers. Flutter 3.27 brings significant upgrades to text selection, especially for desktop and web environments. Here's an example of something that wasn't possible before. Using the Shift key to create selection blocks seamlessly, just as you would in any native application. This enhancement aligns Flutter's text selection capabilities with those of traditional desktop and web apps. Additionally, you can now programmatically create text selections by defining a global key of type selection area state and attaching it to your selection area. You can call the clearSelection method to instantly clear any user-selected text areas. These updates may seem small, but they're crucial for delivering a polished and modern text selection experience in your Flutter web and desktop apps. Flutter 3.27 introduces several enhancements to Cupertino widgets, bringing them closer to native iOS standards and making them more flexible for developers. Additionally, minor fixes across Cupertino widgets improve their responsiveness and visual fidelity, aligning them more closely with Apple's human interface guidelines. These updates may not be flashy, but they make a big difference in creating Flutter apps that feel truly native on iOS. In Flutter 3.27, Impeller has become the default rendering backend for Vulkan on Android, marking a significant step forward in Flutter's rendering capabilities. Impeller is designed to deliver smoother performance and greater reliability, particularly in scenarios that involve complex graphics and animations. By leveraging Vulkan's modern and efficient APIs, Impeller is able to provide a more optimized experience than previous rendering methods. For older Android devices that do not support Vulkan, the default renderer remains Skia, ensuring compatibility and stability across a wide range of devices. While Impeller currently focuses on Vulkan, the Flutter team is putting considerable effort into extending its support to OpenGL in the future. The ultimate goal is to make Impeller the default backend across all platforms, providing consistent and enhanced performance. The Flutter team is actively seeking feedback from developers to refine Impeller further. They encourage the community to test Impeller in their apps and report any issues or suggestions. This feedback will play a crucial role in ensuring Impeller is ready to become the universal rendering engine in future Flutter releases. And that's it for this overview of the most notable improvements in Flutter 3.27. A big thank you to the Flutter team at Google and all the external contributors who worked hard to make this release possible. If you would like to dive deeper into all these updates, we'll find a link to the official blog post with detailed explanations in the video description. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more Flutter content. Thank you for watching this video until the end. I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. Goodbye.